This video covers storage or SAS cabling for new PowerProtect Data Domain 6900 systems. A standard PowerProtect DD6900 system will have 1 to 8 ES40 storage shelves, and an ES40 will have 15 4TB disk drives. This video does not cover how the hardware is mounted in the rack. Please refer to the installation guides for the various components for information on how to rack. If you were to purchase a pre-rack system, this is what it would look like. You can see the PowerProtect DD6900 and the 8 ES40s. These are positioned in the rack to make cabling as simple as possible. There are two reasons for the gap between the DD6900 and the 5th ES40. 1U of the gap is to allow for the cable management arms that are mounted to the rear of the PowerProtect DD6900. The remainder allows for the addition of a second PowerProtect DD6900 that will be used in an HA system. You can drop the ES40s by 3U if you plan to never convert your system to HA. This in turn leaves more space in the rack for equipment if desired. Here is the back view of an ES40. There are two controllers with B on top and A on bottom. The port identifiers that the SAS cable can plug into are on the bottom. This is the back view of a PowerProtect DD6900, showing the location of the SAS controllers and their port identifiers. The blue and green lines represent SAS cables. The blue lines go to the PowerProtect DD6900 controller. On the right hand side, the cable goes from the PCIe SAS card port A to port A of controller A on the top ES40. On the left hand side, the cable goes from the PCIe SAS card port A to port A of controller B on the bottom ES40. The four ES40s here are said to be in the same chain. The green line represents the cables that complete the chain. On the right hand side, it connects port B of controller B on the top ES40 to port A of controller B on the next one down. On the left hand side, it connects port B on controller A on the bottom ES40 to port A of controller A on the next one up. This continues on to complete the chain. In this view, we see how the next four ES40s are connected. In this case, the purple lines represent the cables going from the SAS card port B on the right to the top ES40 and from the SAS card port B on the left to the bottom ES40 of that group. The green lines are connected to the same as the first chain on the bottom. That covers a non-HA PowerProtect DD6900 system. The ES40s are installed from the bottom. Consider the use of an anti-tip mechanism or have the rack bolted to the floor. This shows a full HA configuration. You'll notice that the two chains of the ES40s are in the same position. The cabling here is the same as a non-HA system, with the addition of an FS25, as well as the network cables that interconnect to the second PowerProtect DD6900. For the bottom ES40s, the yellow connections have been added. On the left, they go from the second PowerProtect DD6900 SAS port A to the top ES40 port B of controller A. And on the right, from the SAS port A to the bottom ES40 port B of controller A. For the top chain, red connections have been added. On the left, they go from SAS port B to the top ES40 port B of controller B. And on the right, from SAS port B to port B of controller A on the bottom ES40 of the chain. The third chain for both PowerProtect DD6900s connect to the FS25. From the first PowerProtect DD6900, the orange connections on the left go from SAS port C to the FS25 port A on controller A, and on the right from SAS port C to the FS25 port A of controller B. The light blue connections from the top PowerProtect DD6900 go from the left SAS port C to the FS25 port B of controller A, and on the right from SAS port C to the FS25 port B of controller B. There's a fair amount of flexibility when installing a PowerProtect DD6900 in a rack. These recommendations are based on creating a consistent layout, so we can provide the correct cabling with an order and create a system that is accessible and serviceable. As such, this is not the only way to create a system. Customers may have other requirements. We have rules and guidelines that can be applied to new systems as well as upgrades. These are covered in greater depth in the documentation. For more information about setup and configuration processes for PowerProtect DD, visit support.emc.com.